Hey yo, what is up guys? Welcome back to the channel. As always, keeping you up to date on all the latest. And on this video, we got a lot of news to talk about regarding the brand new WWE 2K Battlegrounds video game. Since the initial reveal of the game, there have been a lot of questions regarding what consoles is going to be coming out, what type of game modes are going to be in the game, what type of interactions are going to be part of our gameplay, besides the crocodile moment that we got to see on the clip, which other OMG or similar things will we be getting? So in this video, we're gonna answer all those questions and discuss the very latest big information that we got in. Before we get into it though, if you guys wanna continue being up to date on all the latest, make sure to subscribe and turn on those notifications. As much like any other WWE game, we will be covering everything related to WWE 2K Battlegrounds. Anyways, let's get right into it. So as soon as we got the initial trailer, we learned that the release date of the game is going to be sometime in fall 2020. It's expected that it could just be October or November, just like the regular WWE 2K games come out. So again, no specifics on the date, but the other big question was, well, what console is the game going to be coming out for? Many fans started wondering that maybe this was just a WWE 2K mobile game. And that is not the case. Based on their Instagram account, they indicated that it is going to be a full-fledged console game. But the biggest confirmation and all the news that we got really comes from the rating of the game, from Entertainment Software Rating Board website, which is already listing WWE 2K Battlegrounds. Legally, ESRB needs to have this information in order to rate the game. So you guys can even check this information out for yourself by going to their website. So when searching up WWE 2K Battlegrounds, the first thing that we get to see is the rating of it and also what consoles the game is gonna be coming out for. The game is already rated Team, which we learned on the trailer, but Entertainment Software Rating Board reveals that it's also going to be coming out for Windows PC, PlayStation 4, Stadia, Xbox One, and interestingly enough, Nintendo Switch. The last WWE game that we got on Nintendo Switch was WWE 2K18, and we all know how horrible that experience was. There is no other way to explain it. The game was unplayable, and they had to rush it out before the holidays to meet deadlines, and it just led to a broken game. So that is the first confirmation that yes, the game is going to be coming out on all of the major consoles. There is no mention of it being on PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X, which are also set to release on fall 2020. Chances are though that this game is going to come out before those consoles come out, maybe a month before it, but we don't know just yet. A bit disappointing that it is not being developed for PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X, as far as we know. Fingers crossed that maybe they reveal it for that next gen console once those consoles are actually confirmed with its release date, but it's unlikely considering that we even had reports from the same source that reveal 2K21 wasn't happening, also indicating that they didn't even have planned for WWE 2K22 to be on that next gen console. Maybe the whole 2K game studio, when it comes to anything related to WWE games, is just not ready yet to develop it for that next gen. Really hoping all of that is wrong though. If not, hopefully backwards compatibility does the work. The website also confirms that there will be in-game purchases on all of these consoles, which more than likely simply means that yes, the game is going to be getting some DLCs after its release, which is not really a shocker. Then we get to a lot of extra information on the rating summary, and this is where the juicy stuff is at. And it states the following. This is an arcade style fighting game in which players engage in wrestling matches using custom characters and WWE superstars. So let's stop right there. Yes, I'm gonna be stopping this while we read this full paragraph, because as I said, there's a lot of information. So right off the bat, this already confirms that yes, there is going to be a creation suite in this game. We are going to be able to create our custom characters and maybe update superstars attire and so on. It is a WWE game after all. It would be kind of weird for it to not have any type of customization. So it's good that we are hearing confirmation in regards to it. It goes on to state the following. Characters punch, kick, and throw each other during matches. And players can also attack opponents by using chairs, poles, alligators, exploding barrels, and falling cars. Yes, falling cars. Like what? Falling out of where and why are cars falling, right? Right now, this just sounds absolutely amazing. So right there, we got a couple of weapons confirmations, and of course them letting us know that it's going to be really interactive. We already saw The Rock tossing John Cena, about to get eaten by an alligator, so there seems to be more craziness just like that. It goes on to say that wrestlers react to damage by crying out in pain and or writhing on the floor, so you know every single move cell is going to be exaggerated. Which is just as expected. Matches are depicted in a somewhat exaggerated cartoon style, highlighted by impact sounds, slow motion effect, and occasional explosions. I don't know about you guys, but I am all down for occasional explosions. I would just love to powerbomb somebody into a car and for it to just go insane. The slow motion effect and even the impact sounds is something that we touched on when we were watching the trailer, as we are able to see the superstars on fire, delivering some of the special moves, whether it is a DDT from all the way up in the air, or a nasty punch, and so on. I like that they're going to add that slow motion effect to it, because it always makes it more impactful. But guys, it gets better, it gets crazier. And this next line, I'm extremely excited for. It indicates the following. In one sequence, wrestlers climb and are shocked by an electrified cage while grabbing bags of cash. I don't know what this is, but it sounds like an electrifying cage money in the bank briefcase match. Who knows? Point is, they're confirmed that we are going to be getting an electrified cage and we need to be grabbing bags of cash. Why we need to grab cash? We don't know. Maybe this is a special type of match that we're going to be getting, which is something that I'm expecting. Of course, we're going to get the regular 1v1, 2v2 matches. I mean, we can only expect, right? But I'm also expecting that they go all out and give us a weird stuff, just like this. Give us an electrifying cage or an electrifying hell in a cell. Give us matches that are just impossible to see on television because in real life we will never get it, and make this game as unique as possible and as wild as it could get. I'm already imagining how crazy the fire is going to be if we do get an Inferno type of match. I mean, I don't see why not. Please give it to us and then just make your own type of version of it, and I'm sure it will be nuts. Continuing with the rating summary, states that some female wrestlers wear outfits that expose a moderate amount of cleavage, which is not really a surprise. So nothing new there, because we are talking about a WWE game anyways. It also goes on to indicate that characters can perform taunt actions that are somewhat suggestive. So much like the outfits, this is something expected. So that is everything indicated in the rating summary. No extra information has been given to us. So this was certainly a lot to know. And although we haven't seen a certain type of interaction moves and probably OMG moments that were indicated here, it really does feel like we are going to be able to do some crazy stuff in this game. So just to recap, the game is going to be coming out on PC, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Stadia, and Nintendo Switch. It is rated team just like all of the other WWE 2K games. And when it comes to gameplay, it is putting a heavy focus on exaggerating things. From having explosion, a superstar getting eaten by alligators, using chair, doing some type of special regarding falling cars, and in a lot of its special animations, it uses slow motion effect, impact sound, more explosion, and so on. The other big confirmation that we got is that there will be custom characters, so we are getting a creation suite. And I know it's going to be weird if we do get something like a community creation where people get to upload it and others get to download it, but that online feature needs to be there. I want to be able to have a full stacked up roster, and the only way that will be possible is with a complete community creation. It will also extend the life of the game, just like it does to every single WWE 2K game. The creation suite doesn't have to be that deep, since this is cartoon-based superstars anyways, but at least just have the basic tools in it so that we could get by and create whoever we want to create. Anyways, guys, that is what I got for you in this video. If you enjoyed the coverage or found it informative, don't forget to elbow drop it, and of course, have those notifications turned on so that you could continue being up to date on everything regarding WWE 2K Battlegrounds. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below of anything that we ended up discussing today. And of course, what else would you like to see? Which game modes do you guys want to see return to this game? Which current superstar slash legends you wanted to be in it? And so on. I'll catch you guys on the next one, so stay savage.